Part Talbot versus Afan Lido. Last season, this saw one of the most dramatic ends to a season that there has ever been. Talbot needed a positive result if they were going to survive the drop, whilst Afan Lido were very intent on sending them down. Today is a different story, and what a massive 5 months it has been for Part Talbot Town. When we last faced Afan Lido in the Steel Derby, we had only 6 wins from 29 games, losing 15. Today, we have won 6 out of 11, losing only 2. The team is playing with a spark, the strikers banging goals in for fun. 6 points separate the teams today, with Port Talbot sitting in 4th and Lido in 9th. But for Port Talbot fans, today is more about than just beating their biggest rivals. It's about making amends for the embarrassment last season and showing South Wales that there's a new top dog in town, with a whole lot of bark and a whole lot of bite. So, according to goal, Afan Lido are slight underdogs in what should prove a tightly contested affair against Port Talbot. Looking down, they have no real selection problems going into the game, but obviously we've got John Hall, who's recovering from a pulled hamstring, and last game, we'll get into it in a minute, Adam Hesp got sent off, which I wasn't too pleased about, to be honest. If we're looking over at their form, they've only won 1 game in the last 5, whilst we've won all 5 of them, which is great, but we're hoping it doesn't lead to complacency in this game. That'd be worst case scenario. We really don't want to go into this game complacent. I'm just going to go over to the dynamics and hold a team meeting, try and encourage them a bit more. Wanted to take a moment to say how pleased I am with the recent upturn in form. Let's keep it going. And I think that's got what I came for. Everyone's very positive, very happy, encouraged. So I think we're all optimistic about our chances of keeping this going. Who knows what we could achieve if that happens. That's exactly what I was looking for. Just trying to build their morale up for this game because it's a big one and I don't really want it to drop massively if we do lose it. So, got to try and manage this game very, very well because it is such a big game for not just the fans, the players. They've got a lot riding on this game and it's early on in the season. It'll make a massive statement. And more importantly, I don't want to lose this game and go into a bit of a losing rut because that happens all the time and that'd be the worst thing possible. So, let's get into the tactics. I almost forgot, but our last game, because obviously we said this, I think Ribwa BC game last episode. So since then we played Treffel and BGC, and you know who already scored? It's Ben Fassett. Of course it was. I believe it was a Morgan Jones assist as well. And what I was absolutely fuming about, Adam Hesp getting sent off in the 90th minute. Is there any need for that? 90th minute, you can just hold on with 1-0 up. There's no need to make rash challenges. But yeah, he got his second yellow card and that was that. So we are without him this game. If we go over to the team selection, I did just quickly select this now. Missing important centre-back. We've had to bring Emblin Jones in and to be honest, he hasn't played at all for us in the league this season. He's one of those signings we made last season, but we're without John Hall, Adam Hesp, our two real good backup centre-backs. So, yeah, Emblin Jones is going to have to step up today massively. Dan Parry on the left, Richardson on the left, pretty much all the same. Got Wally on the right, who I might swap him out for Evans later on into the game. Decided to go a bit more balanced mentality as opposed to attacking, and I'm going to just stop the creative freedom for now. I know we are playing very well, but I don't want to rush into this game too much, being away from home and what a big game it is. I'm going to also work the ball into the box, try and make the most of the chances we do get. So yeah, that's how we're going to line up. I'm nervous, excited. I think more excited because of the form we're in. So yeah, let's go and get it. So the lineups are in, and this is my first chance to have a look at Afan Lido's lineup compared to last season. A lot of different names. There's no Tyrone Afari, I've noticed up top. I remember Joseph Jones, a captain, and James Parry, I believe. He played for them last season, but now there's a lot of new names in there. Is there any way out? Well, I'll have a look in a minute at how many transfers they made throughout the summer, but it looks like they've got a lot. Paolo Mendes, Harry Fuller, Jack Kenny and Luke Oliver might have just been behind Tyrone Afari up top, but I don't recognise a lot of these names in comparison to last season, especially when we had Adam Jenkins, Taylor Williams, Wally, Waters, Emblin Jones, Ben Fassett. We had all them players, but I could be wrong. Maybe I'm just not recognising the names, but I think they've had a lot of changes. Looking at some of the social roundup, Florence Attlee saying, get Emblin Jones out of the team, I can't help having him in. He's the only centre-back we've got which is fit, which can go in there, so fuck off, Florence. Connor Thompson, Parry starts, that's good. Reece Hales, a bit nervous for this one despite Jones's form. So am I, but I'm hoping they can bring us through it. Right, we are favourites. Let's get out there and show them why. I have faith. Get out there and make a difference. Okay, then. And this is the first Steel Derby of the season. It's probably the one I've been most confident about winning. And yeah, let's get into it. I remember Radford from last season, actually. I do remember Radford. But looks like we have the first highlight as Dan Parry's trying to break down the left-hand side. Can he make his way past? Can he get across in? Wins the corner. We're happy with that. We don't mind that one bit. Dan Parry, what can he do? Whips the ball in. Oliver head clears. Dan Parry back in again. It's gone all the way to the back post. Wally finds Waters. Jenkins to Jones. Williams with a shot, which is blocked. Dan Parry with a shot, which is also blocked. And it looks like they're trying to counter-attack with Fuller on the right-hand side. Okay. Jenkins now with a ball whipped in. Nothing could come of it. Richardson with a great ball back out wide to Jenkins. Trying the same ball in. Headed clear. Looks like we're just trying to find a ball in behind their defence at the moment. As it worked. And Ben Fassett. How good is he? That's his 11th goal already. 11. Emblin Jones with the assist, I believe it was. Yeah, we were trying a lot of these balls. We know how dangerous Ben Fassett is when he gets behind the defence. And naughty little ball over the top. Tight offside call, apparently. No, it's not tight at all. Not tight at all. Ben Fassett, what a finish. So, brilliant start to the Steel Derby. Just going to try and keep it, I guess, reserved now. Slow the pace down. Don't try anything too expressive, because we don't want to give the ball away a lot. Dan Parry looks to whip the ball in. Taylor Williams with a great head. What a save that is by their keeper. What a save. Just trying to figure out what formation they're using there. I did see it for a brief second, but soon missed it again as Waters finds Morgan Jones, who heads it onto the set. Let's have a look at their formation now then. Okay. Well, they got Joseph Jones in defensive mid, which we knew he was very, very effective at as last season. Kenny up top, Oliver and Fuller on the wing. I think we'll find some space in behind there. It's going to be hard trying to break through the middle. So, yeah, I'm happy with how we're playing at the moment. Again, we've been in such good defensive form at the moment. I don't think we've conceded a goal this month. I know we haven't conceded in the last four games, but just look at the shots they've had. They've only had one shot and one on target, an XG of 0.04. Our defence is absolutely solid. And it might be down to Cartwright being on a clean sheet bonus, but I don't know. You've got to give him it if it's guaranteeing these results. So, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant going into half-time. things are going very well, but I'm oh shit, I didn't mean to click that one. Oh, you weren't bad, but I believe you can improve. Have faith. Oh god, I feel well bad on the defence now. I've just ripped into him. I mean, at least Cartwright and Richardson have took it in a good way, but Emblem Jones, Waters and Mayer, they're demotivated. That's not what we wanted. Emblem Jones is actually having quite a decent game, considering Florence wanted him out. But if we can hold on to a 1-0 win in the first Steel Derby of the season, very, very, very pleased with that. We'll be very pleased. I think a change we'll make on the 60 is swap out Dan Parry for Richard Brock. 16-year-old who's making a lot of appearances so far off the bench. Very pleased with him. As Parry looks the ball in, Jones can't get a header onto it, but Jenkins picks it up. And I've noticed Adam Jenkins has been so, so effective at that role this season. Oh, what a goal that is, Wally. Great ball from Jones, but what a finish. Just in the right position. I mean, he did look a bit offside, but we're going to find out from this replay. Waters back to Jones. Oh, he's well on. Well on again. Is that Bradford playing him onside again? I think he played Fassett onside for the first goal. Look at that, coolly slots it into the far left corner. 2-0, Afan Lido. Steel Derby, are they even our rivals anymore? We're going to new heights now, new heights. Absolutely brilliant. I am going to go ahead and bring Dan Parry off for Richard Brock. Give him a bit of a chance out there, and I believe I've got Stead on the bench, I do. So Richardson can come off as Kenny looks to find a goal. Good save by Mayer. 1-1, they should have really equalised there, but not complaining. Callaghan, bad ball in. Mayer can collect that quite easy. But no, very, very, very pleased with how we've played so far. Oh, and our clean sheet record has been broken. Callaghan, ball into the box. Craig Rogers with the goal. Too easy, really. We should be challenging for that header, but it's a goal from a set piece. Not too pleased with that, but if we can hold on for the 3 points, I'll be very, very, very pleased. So we've just got to try and hold on now. Going to ask them to play a bit more cautious. Cartwright not having the best game, so I'm going to bring on Evans. As they look for an equaliser now. Ooh, that was close. Redford over the top for Rogers. Was it Rogers? I couldn't work out who it was, who had the shot. I think it was Rogers. Could be wrong. Mayer collects calmly. They've had quite a few shots in the past 15, 20 minutes, so I've got to try and keep this under Lockie now. Stead gives the ball away to Kenny, and it looks like they're going to counter us. Fuller on the right-hand side. Kenny slots it into the bottom left corner, and it's 2-2. That's disappointing. 2-0 up, and I thought it was in the bag. And it's a simple counter-attack. Jones to Fuller. Stead who gave the ball away and then can't make a tackle on Fuller. Kenny unmarked. Well, no one really challenging him for the ball. Just has all the time in the world to slot in. And I'd say they don't deserve it, but to be honest, they do. They do deserve it. Not too pleased at all. So now it's just a case of trying to hold on for the 1 point. I've kind of left us exposed on the right-hand side, but can Evans break forward here? Barnes Jenkins. Jenkins goes back to Waters. Waters over to Jones for set. Disallowed. I knew it would be. He's well offside. Pretty stupid position to be stood in for a striker, to be honest, but well offside in the end. Let's have a look at that. I mean, what's his thought process here? I don't know. Unless he thought a defender would get a flick on it instead of Jones. Naughty finish, but disappointed, really. Emblem Jones heads clear to the right-hand side. Azair Jones looks for a ball over the top. And that is it. 2-2. Away from home. I'd say I wasn't disappointed, but to be honest, I am, because we were 2-0 up. We had chances to kill the game off. Ronan Wally's injured now, which isn't good for us, and I'd say they're unlucky. Just to, you know, keep them a bit confident. But I personally, I'm quite disappointed in that. To be 2-0 up and to throw it away and let them in for a 1 point. I mean, we move on. What was Swansea Uni? Swansea Uni drew 0-0 with Haverford West, who are sixth. So that's a little consolation, I guess. We are not too far off them now. 7 points in it. Yeah, so onwards and upwards from here, I guess. Carl Messam is absolutely fuming with that, and I can see why. Summer Ashcroft, shocking, absolutely shocking. We could have finished it off, we really could have, but at the end of the day, it is what it is. We move on. 5 unbeaten for Port Talbot following the draw, which is still good. Still good. Not too bad at all. Looking at the schedule. Yeah, so we were on a 4 clean sheet streak until that game. But our next game is Carlion in the JD Welsh Cup second round, and they're in the Welsh Tier 4. I mean, I struggled to find anything about, Seffin Cribwell, who are in the Welsh Tier 5, but it's not a bad draw, really, in hindsight. Should be winning that, and it should be going into the third round of the JD Welsh Cup, and I'm trying to hope we do go on a bit of a cup run this season, because I think that'd be quite good for the series, and of course it'd be nice to win something, but I know when we start facing the big teams like Swansea Uni, TNS, Bangor City, that it's going to get very, very difficult. Anyway, that is episode 5. I hope you enjoyed. I think the next game will probably be against Swansea Uni. Got quite a few games in between, but none of them are really important. Haverford West, who I've just got relegated, be quite an important one, but to be honest, I think Swansea Uni is going to be on my next one in January, so yeah, I'll try and pump out video for then. If I decide to get one in before then, probably look at one in December. I've got one on the 11th of December, Lampwick Major, which could be a good one. But yeah, I'll see when the next video is going to be out. I do really want to look forward to this Swansea Uni game, though, because they are the team to beat so far, and they beat us 4-1. Yeah, 4-1 at the beginning of the season, so it would be nice to get some revenge on them, because we have been inspired form. I mean, look, over the last 2 months, we've only lost one and drawn one. So, not too bad at all. Anyway, my name's elGee. If you've liked the video, please drop a like. If you want to stay up to date with the series, hit subscribe. Hope you all have a great night. Peace out.